Oh, Flak Jacket, you beautiful perk, you. You keep me safe whenever the enemy team becomes noob tube crazy, or if I need to capture a flag. Oh, I love these so much. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Gorilla Hands, and today I'm going to talk a little bit about one of my favorite perks for objective game modes, especially in Domination. It's Flak Jacket. And what you'll see from the gameplay is a big reason why I love using Flak Jacket, especially in maps like Nuketown and Firing Range. I didn't go straight to the B flag in this game. I actually decided to hold the right side because I played with this team the game before, and the host quit midway, but my team was really, really good at running straight to the B flag and capturing it. So I decided I'd kind of camp, post up next to the right side to make sure they could push flanks. And you kind of get two advantages if you have somebody post up on that right side. One, you kind of set up a basic spawn trap, so you keep people from sniping in that second floor building and pushing from the right side. And the other big advantage, you don't really see it in this game, but sometimes you'll get a stalemate for B, like neither team can grab it. So one of the ways to break that stalemate is to move around to the enemy team's spawn flag, which would have been A, our spawn flag, and capture that to kind of break up that stalemate. And to prevent that, you need people kind of spread across that front line. So just in case we couldn't cap B, I was holding the right side to make sure they didn't pull around and grab our spawn flag. You might have noticed I survived that Jeep exploding while the guys around me didn't. And of course, that's because I'm wearing Flak Jacket. And the reason I really enjoy Flak Jacket, especially for objective game modes, is if you're playing by yourself, sometimes it can be really difficult to meet your objectives, like to capture that B flag. And that's just because your team may not be pushing the enemy team back enough. So if they're within range to chuck grenades at that point, there's not a whole lot you can do while you're capping the flag. I mean, if it pushes you off the flag, it will reset the timer and you gotta go back. And if it's Semtex, you can't pick it up and chuck it back, so you're kinda at the mercy of those explosives. So Flak Jacket, I think, is one of the better perks for being an offensive objective player in something like Domination. And the other reason that I really enjoy Flak Jacket is, coming from Modern Warfare 2, the one thing that just plagued that game, I know I probably sound like a broken record, but one-man army, danger close, noob tubes. And sometimes I hear people say, well, you could have used the, what was it, the iron mask or whatever it was called, that piece of equipment that reduced explosive damage in Modern Warfare 2. But from what I remember, it reduced it by 40%. So if somebody's using danger close, which increases it by 40%, then all it does is bring that explosive damage down to its original damage. So you're not really getting that much of a benefit from it. And on top of that, while you're wearing that mask, you don't have a radar. So it really wasn't very beneficial, and it took up an equipment slot, so it was not a very feasible or very useful in a lot of situations. But here, though, it's actual perk slot. It's not taking up any equipment, and there's no danger close modifier in this game, so I mean, it's extremely powerful. And I have heard complaints that some people seem to think it's a little too powerful. If I know that the enemy team's using Flak Jacket, I don't use noob tubes, so I don't really know how effective they are against someone using Flak Jacket. But I do know that if I make a conscious effort to adjust the cook time on my frag grenades or the arc on my Semtex, I can still kill them. You're not invincible to explosives when you're wearing Flak Jacket. So if you cook it long enough, and throw it in such a way that it detonates kind of midair next to the person, or at least near their feet, they're still going to die. I mean, it's not you're not 100% immune to these explosives. You're just resistant to explosives. There's another amazing thing called a gun. So if somebody's running Flak Jacket, you can just shoot them. So I don't really find it to be, this super overpowered perk that some people seem to view it as. And also, I mean, again, one of the advantages that I find using something like Flak Jacket, whenever I'm playing a game mode like Firing Range, if I clear out the B flag, I clear everybody who's guarding it, you will still spawn within range to chuck a grenade at the B flag. So if I kill everybody there and then I start capping the B flag, I'm completely defenseless to everybody who's just now respawning and chucking grenades at that point. If you have a frag grenade, it's going to land next to me with like a half a second fuse and it's going to explode, so I can't really toss it back. And Semtex is actually going to blow up right above my head, so there's nothing I can do to avoid that. So unless I'm, you know, if I'm playing by myself, the only option really in that situation to cap the B flag without dying is to wear a flak jacket. I can't really find much purpose to use flak jacket in a game mode like TDM, unless I'm playing an entire enemy team that's using noob tubes. Then I'll probably take it out just to combat that. But for the most part, it doesn't serve much purpose for me whenever I'm playing that game type. Another thing you may have noticed, since I've been doing these videos, I've kind of been looking around at different things like video editing and special effects. And I looked up something called Adobe After Effects and Final Cut Pro. And those things are extremely, extremely expensive. So I was like, well, I guess I'm going to have to pass on doing those special effects for these videos for now. But then I did a little bit more digging, and I found an open source tool called Blender. And for those of you who may not know what open source is, it's basically something that's kind of developed by the community. The source code is available to everybody to edit and add in the modifications they choose. So this tool is 100% free. I already have it downloaded, didn't have to pay anything at all, and it's available to everybody. And the great thing is, since it's open source, it's always being updated with new and innovative features. And what this tool basically does is, you know, if you've ever seen a movie like Pixar's Up, the tools they use to make those movies is what this tool basically does. They didn't develop that movie with Blender, but you can get very close to those details using this tool. So I downloaded it and I've been tinkering with it. I will say, it's got an amazingly deep learning curve. It's very steep. It's very difficult to work with it and learn it. But I'm going to be working with it for a little while, and hopefully I'll be able to generate kind of special effects and animations to add to this video. But for anybody who's like an aspiring artist or maybe even thinking about doing game development or anything like that, I would suggest trying this out. It's free to download. There's a lot of tutorials and wikis and manuals on how to use this. And you know, it's absolutely free, so you can do a lot of practice with it if you're ever interested. And it's not just animation, it's also imaging. So if you have like a picture that you wanted to create in CGI, you can do that as well. And you know, I saw some of the things you could do with it. There's a smoke effect, and I'll include it in a link in the description. But I saw that and I was like, well, you know, I can't do a meet your fellow form with a smoke until I'm able to figure out how to do this effect. Cause I mean, it's like, it's awesome. It's you know, get this smoke effect and have it reveal his name. I'm thinking about doing stuff like that, for, you know, a lot of different people and a lot of different videos and finding ways to add that stuff in. So, I actually included, an animation that I did in this video at the end. It was I had to take a tutorial on how to develop the image, and then I had to look all over the place to figure out how to do the animations. Unfortunately, I'm so new to the animations, I couldn't add the sway and rotation and actual weight to make it look real, or as real as I'd like it to. But I'm going to be working on that and other things and hopefully improving on it. So I don't know if you have any questions about Blender. I certainly don't mind talking about it in the future. And also, if you guys have any ideas for what would make for a cool image or animation, please let me know, because, you know, it'd be cool to kind of develop some of this stuff. But as always, guys, take it easy.